So today we're going to go out and stock our first ever batch of captive propagated and reared Ozark Hellbenders.
There's 113 total.
Look how orange they are.
Oh,
totally awesome.
Our hope is that with restocking efforts, we will actually bolster or supplement any existing population in hopes that we might move the needle into the positive side.
So this is the Ozark Hellbender. An animal that's been declining for many, many years, and we're trying to do our best to save this animal right now. So over the past 10 to 12 years, we've been actually captive breeding them, removing eggs from the wild, raising them at the St. Louis Zoo, and this will actually be our first day of the official release of animals back into the 11 Point River on the Arkansas side.
We have 113 animals.
I'm doing
34 animals here.
Yeah.
I think we can do that here.
62-95-197. 56-81-861.
It was a historic moment for Ozark Hellbender conservation. Partners from the Arkansas Game and Fish Commission and Missouri Department of Conservation released 113 young hellbenders, marking the first introduction of captive-bred Ozark hellbenders into Arkansas's portion of the 11 Point River, an important step forward in the recovery of this endangered species.
Our work continues here on the 11 Point River population, though, by putting what we call nest boxes into the river, and also hopefully in the fall, we check these boxes in the month of October in hopes that we can actually find a clutch of eggs in the boxes to then take to the St. Louis Zoo, which is our collaborator in captive propagation program with the Missouri Department of Conservation.
Well, back in 2002, Missouri Department of Conservation, St. Louis Zoo kind of went into a cooperative agreement to start providing space for hellbenders. And we wanted to try to captively breed them first and foremost. And it actually took us about 8 years before we were successful in 2011 getting our first groups to captively breed. So far, we've released about 3,500 animals into Missouri streams, and we're slowly monitoring those animals. Our first research project showed that based on the size lengths, if they're about 6 to 8 inches in size, about 50% survival occurs for the first couple of years. So we know some are surviving. So our next major milestone for us in our state and even in Arkansas is to find an animal we raised from an egg released into the wild that actually we can prove that they successfully reproduced. And we're hoping that will occur this year.
Found nowhere else in the world besides southern Missouri and northern Arkansas, these unique salamanders face many obstacles on their road to recovery.
This animal's been declining for a while now. There's not very many left in the wild. And we're trying to figure out the reasons for decline, from diseases, habitat changes, to increased predation.
And that's the $64,000 question as to why our populations of hellbenders have declined. We don't have any hard empirical data to say is this one specific cause.
But when we did modeling exercises to look at the long-term stability of the population, we saw that we're probably going to lose this animal in about 10 to 12 years if we didn't do anything. So we invested a lot of resources into the propagation end to basically not only buy us time to learn the reason for decline, but to hopefully just by putting a sheer number of animals back, they'll start reproducing naturally on their own and the populations will increase.
Time will tell. All we can do is try at this point. And in face of all these other extraneous issues, external issues, we can only try it. This is our last hope. Otherwise, perhaps, yeah, we might be able to maintain them in captivity in perpetuity, but animals will have much of a place to live in the wild if things continue on the course we're on right now, I feel.
So we have to work together, and we've been doing that for years, from searching for eggs, building nest boxes, starting to release animals. I mean, there's no choice to save this animal. We have to work together from a watershed standpoint.
Bringing back the Ozark Hellbender won't be easy, but projects like this provide a glimmer of hope in the dark recesses beneath the surface of the 11 Point River.